So one of the things on my wish list for this year is a big hunkin' telescope. From what I understand, most of them use mirrors to reflect light. Now this guy's a little different. What's the story with this?
Yeah, this is the Explore Scientific. It's an 80 millimeter apochromatic telescope. And what it uses to focus in on distant objects is a series of lenses. But the problem with most telescopes that use lenses like that is that you get a lot of interference with colors and with detail. So what this guy does is that it focuses in on the three primary colors, so red, yellow, and blue. And what that does is it gives you much truer colors and better detail on things.
But how expensive is it?
So it's $800.
It looks pretty pro, but that's actually not that unreasonable.
No, not at all. You see, like the telescopes you're talking about before, the ones that use mirrors, are way more expensive. They run thousands of dollars. This one's only $800. So if you were, say, an amateur astronomer or somebody who wanted to like get into astronomy, this is actually a really good way to go. It's actually great too because it has this mount on it that lets you put it onto any tripod. So say you have
a standard mount. That's
it's
great.
It's a standard tripod mount. So yeah, so if you have a tripod or you know that you use
or
for photography,
or a tabletop one,
exactly, you can just throw it on that and you're good to go.
Now it also comes with a small hard case. And what you can do is you can break down all the pieces, put it in the case, lock it up, and travel around with it, and it doesn't matter if you knock it around because you're not going to get a cracked lens.
Yeah, I mean, really, there's really nothing worse than a cracked lens.
No, except for maybe like a stolen lens.
Yeah, where do you think I got this? So, Steven, on my wish list this year, I want something that will really upgrade my stereo equipment. I want something that will deliver like better sound, but also kind of looks cool. It's not like a nondescript black box. What have you got for me?
Well, what you just described is exactly this, which is Niehaus Laboratory's T2 amplifier. Now, it's a vacuum tube amp.
Okay.
It has a stainless steel body. It has gold inputs in the back, which cuts down on all the resonance and things like that, so there's less buzzing when digital and analog signals go through.
Oh, so there's like less popping and hissing.
Yeah, much more popping and locking. So what else is cool about this thing is that in the back, it's got a USB port and a SPDIF optical port.
Whoa, slow down there, Thomas Alva Edison. Tell me, what does that allow me to do?
So what you can do is you can take your computer and you can pump digital files direct into this guy.
Oh, that's really cool.
And so you skip the sound card in your computer, which normally takes a digital file and condenses it down to then spit it into an analog signal to put through your speakers.
So Steven, these vacuum tubes on the front here, are they decorative or they actually have a function?
No, absolutely. So the problem with digital music in general and everyone complains about is that you lose a lot of these sort of subtleties and intricacies.
Yeah, it sounds cool.
Exactly. Right. So what these do is they add a little bit of warmth and texture to the music that you normally only get with an analog signal.
That's really cool. So how much is this guy?
$795.
Whoa, that's kind of a lot. Do you think it's worth it?
Absolutely. Despite being a vacuum, this thing does not suck.